Yo, what's up, family? Long time no see from Twisted VSC. Ooh, that was bars unintentionally. Oh my God, that was another one. I'm on the roll. I'm on the roll. All right, but if you're interested in playing Second Life or you're just new and you're starting out, I'm going to try to help you today, and I'm going to give you five important things you should know beforehand and why they're important. So get your drinks ready, get your snacks ready, get comfortable, do what you got to do, and let's talk about it.
I ain't got nothing for hoes unless she the one that buy my soul. Out of town, in and out coupes. I miss my brother, so I got four doors. Everything we say true. You live your life trying to press them hoes.
K9, I'm about to lose. I risk my life just to wake up sober.
Alright, so first thing off the bat, Second Life is definitely expensive. Second Life is going to tap your pockets, bro. So buying in-game currency is definitely necessary. In 2K, you know, they call it VC. IMU, they call it credit. Second Life, they call it Lendens, or L's for short, whatever you want to call it. So definitely just like just starting out, you're going to want to buy Lendens. You're probably going to want to spend like a good $50 when you start your account. That's just to get the ball rolling. Most people probably pay between like $40 and $100, maybe 20, maybe 20. But again, most people pay like 40 through 100 to kind of just buy Lendens and get everything they need and stuff like that. Most people actually have jobs or a service to make some of that money back. Like a lot of people are DJs, decorators, landscapers, shit, barbers, all like creators. They make clothes. Some people are even strippers, like escorts, all types of stuff. I think you definitely should have a side hustle. Like this is a game for hustlers. Like if you can hustle and you can kind of make some of that bread back, I definitely encourage you to do so, because it can get really expensive, especially when you don't have anything or you're not doing anything to kind of make some of that back in return. It can get really expensive over time. Like just having the land alone. Okay, I'll break this down to you as like a little bonus. When you start off, you don't have a land. You're homeless. Like they're just gonna drop you some random spot, to be honest. So for you to buy a land, it's gonna cost you per week. So let's just say for this example, your land costs 1,000 Lendens per week. You have to make sure you have 1,000 Lendens on your account. You have to go to whatever place it is to, pay that 1,000 Lendens so you can keep your own personal land, no matter what you have on there or not. Buying a house, that's still going to cost you, decorating, that's still going to cost you. Like just having that rent, just having a place to be to where you're not bothering nobody, like even still, just that simple thing alone, like it's going to cost you. It can get very expensive over time, like I said. And then plus just making your avi up front, like it's going to cost you a lot. I think a head or a body costs about like 5,000 L's. 5,000 L's costs like $20 on its own. A head is going to cost you 5,000, and that's $20 in real life just to get 5,000. So just imagine how expensive that is. See, like I'm not joking about this, man. So make sure you got the bread, because Second Life is going to tap your pockets. Moving on with number two though, Second Life takes patience. I've learned like the best way to learn Second Life is pretty much through trial and error. Yeah, like you're gonna mess up creating your avi or decorating your home, creating products and learning how to create whatever you want to create, even just having like your desired quality settings. Like maybe you want your quality to look ultra super duper realistic. Like that takes time to learn, because there's so much that go into each of those things and everything else that you might want to do. If you're one of those guys that kind of just want to learn Second Life in like 2 days, like it's not going to happen. I promise you, it's not going to happen. You know, you learn something new every day, no matter what. If you have time to invest in Second Life, that's amazing. The stuff you can do on Second Life is almost limitless, so I highly doubt it. Be in it for the long road. You know, if you don't get your avi done or you don't get something done the first day, you know, at least you learned a little bit today, because you tried something, you failed. Go back at it tomorrow, or go back on it, you know, after work or after school or whatever you're doing. Over time, you'll get it. You'll get it. Number three is that Second Life is an adult based platform. Like this is for adults for sure. If you Google it, like the average user is 32 years old. I think that's the oldest in any virtual world game, to be honest with you. I don't think anyone averaging 32 years old on any other virtual world game. And plus, like, it just encourages responsibility, so it's not really surprising to me. Back to number one, like, if you're not spending money, it encourages you to kind of have like a job and to create and to provide a service so you can kind of make your money back. All that stuff is kind of, you know, just adult things to do. And then kind of the biggest reason on why I'm saying this is because, like, it's almost unavoidable to, like, not see the mature and sexual content. Like, it is beyond normal. You're going to see some skin, you're going to see some activity, you're going to see some things. So if you're not mature enough to kind of handle that, or, you know, maybe you might want to, you know, play Second Life for those reasons, I don't know. But I'm just saying, like, this is a mature game. This is definitely recommended for adults. If you're young, you shouldn't be playing this. I think everyone I know that plays Second Life is probably 21 and up. Yeah, I think there's a reason for that. Not because of all the sexual stuff, but, like, it takes a lot of time. You know, kids kind of just want stuff that's free, easy, fun. Second Life isn't fun all the time. It's really like a second life. Like, it's a second responsibility. There's definitely more adults than anything on this game. And even still, you'll meet people older than 32. There's people playing this, I'm sure they're in their 40s, they're in their 50s, 60s, maybe even higher. But just make sure you're aware of that. Of course, there's an exception to it. I'm pretty sure there's some teenagers, or, you know, some people that are young that started playing Second Life. Don't get me wrong, there's an exception to everything. But the majority, like most of the pie, are, you know, young adults and older. Going on with number four, there are no instructions. there are no instructions, like, whatsoever. Are there instructions? Is there a tutorial? I don't think there's a tutorial. I don't know. I don't think there's a tutorial, bro. Like, once you pick a default avi, like, they just jump you straight in. Like, you're just in it now. You figure everything else on your own. Now, I think they do that on purpose because they kind of want you to make Second Life however you want to make Second Life. It's very normal to ask other players for help when you're first starting out. There's a lot of friendly people that will help you out too. Like, you'll probably see someone, you know, at a store, or, you know, somewhere to where you can find things that you could just send them a message, or you could type it, or you, if you're on like voice chat or whatever, you might ask someone for help. People will help you. That's one of the great things about Second Life, is that people will help you if you need help. Like, it's not that hard to kind of just like reach out. Now, of course, if you're shy, you got anxiety, and, you know, all that other stuff, it could be hard talking to people. I understand that, because, you know, I kind of had my moments. I was kind of the same way. Luckily, I had friends that helped me out when I first started, and they just wanted me to play. So I was fortunate enough to have people help me when I first started. Again, like, going back to number two, like, this is a trial and error based game. So, you know, based on there's no instructions, like, they're not going to tell you what to do and what not to do and all that stuff. Like, anything's possible. You can buy whatever, you can do whatever. There isn't really any restrictions behind anything, so you can do what you want. And a part of that is not showing you how to do something if you can do what you want. That makes sense, right? I think that makes sense. All right, here's number five. And I think number five is probably the most, I'd say this is the most important point that I have to make. Second Life is not meant for regular computers. Now, when I say that, I mean, like, Second Life, just as the game itself, it's very stressful, it's very powerful, it takes up a lot of space, a lot of data. It doesn't give you a virus or nothing like that. I know a lot of people kind of, you know, who aren't into virtual world games, they think virtual world stuff kind of like can fuck up your computer and give you viruses and all that other types of stuff. It doesn't, trust me, it doesn't. But you will see how weak your computer is if you get Second Life. It's made for gaming computers, so if you don't have a gaming computer or a gaming laptop, I don't recommend it. Even just like the simple stuff, like, you really won't be able to walk around or anything like that. It determines your entire experience, honestly, depending on what computer you have, how strong your computer is, and can your computer hold the graphics and stuff like that. I definitely recommend you have a gaming computer or a gaming PC when playing Second Life, because it can be very unplayable. Please make sure that your computer is strong enough before you even think about playing Second Life, because if you just have a normal, regular, schmegular computer, and I'm not downing nobody for having a regular computer, but I've learned this through experience. Like, before I got my gaming laptop that I currently use now, I just had like a regular HP from Walmart. I think was like $300. And don't get me wrong, like, it's a good computer, but it's not meant for gaming whatsoever. This isn't 3D pinball, bro. Like, This is a very intense, very graphics based game. So if you want to get into it, I definitely suggest that you have a strong PC for that. And that's my top five, bro. I think I covered the most important things I wanted to cover. Everything else kind of falls in between these top five things. But yo, if you're watching and you're experienced with Second Life, definitely leave a comment down below and tell me something that I missed. Maybe there's something I didn't say that I left out that you feel is important. Maybe I hit it right on the money. Tell me what your opinion is in the comments down below. I don't know everything. Like I said, I'm still learning Second Life, but I just felt like these are the most popular things people should know before even playing Second Life. So if I helped you out, leave a comment down below. Let your boy know that I helped you out. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, we cool. Like, you know, we family. Like, just let me know. And yeah, man. So thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Like, comment, subscribe, and peace.